I'm Mark Nieuwenhuijsen. I'm a professor here at ISGlobal. I'm also the director of the Urban Planning, Environment and Health Initiative. And my main research area is the relationship between urban and transport planning and health. What we see at the moment, a lot of cities are car dominated, there is not enough green space, and this leads to high air pollution levels, high noise levels, urban heat island effects, and also a lack of green space and lack of physical activity in cities. About 2-3 years ago, different databases came available that we could extend our work to many more cities in Europe, almost 1,000 cities in Europe. Then with a few PhD students, we started working on this and putting the different databases together and start estimating what is the burden in Europe related to different exposures. There are two different exposures. NO2, nitrogen dioxide, mainly comes from cars. PM2.5, a little bit from cars, but also other sources like coal, industry, household heating, this kind of things. Our initial work, we focused on air pollution because we know it's a big problem. And so we looked at this kind of almost 1,000 cities, you know, what are the air pollution levels and what is the mortality burden related to air pollution in the cities. And we found that almost 200,000 people die each year prematurely because of the high air pollution levels we have in the cities. To do this type of work, you need to know, you know, where are the cities exactly. You need to have information on city boundaries. You need to have information on exposure levels in cities like air pollution, green space. And then, you know, putting this information together, you can start estimating what is the health burden related to these exposures and thereby also to urban and transport planning. When you look at our estimates, for example, what we see is that the air pollution levels for nitrogen dioxide are highest in cities where there is a lot of traffic around. Often these are big capitals like Madrid, Paris, London. You have a lot of nitrogen dioxide exposure. But then we also found for particulate matter that particularly in cities in Poland, in Czech Republic, Northern Italy, the use of coal and industry actually led to much higher levels of particulate matter, and that led to a high mortality burden. So the next thing what we did was green space. We know that green space is an issue in cities. Many cities don't have enough space for green space. So we did the same exercise. We estimated how much green space is there in the cities, in this particular 1,000 cities, and then related that, you know, the kind of lack of green space, how many deaths does that cause each year. We estimated that just over 40,000 deaths per year are probably caused by the lack of green space in the cities. So now we have a database. We have a database that we put on a website that you can visit, isglobalranking.org. So cities can go in there, can look what is the burden of mortality related to air pollution, to green space in their city. And hopefully soon also in relation to noise, heat island effects. So now cities can't say we don't know what is the health burden related to its exposures. What we see from our databases is that the current urban and transport planning practices have a large impact on health, particularly on mortality. So our cities should improve their current practices. One of the main things is should be to reduce private car use in cities, because that's one determinant of air pollution levels, in particular for nitrogen dioxide. But they also take up a lot of spacing in cities. And so we should shift from private car use to public and active transportation. Active transportation, like walking and cycling, also has the advantage that people get physical activity, and physical activity is extremely important for people's health. The other thing is greening of cities. So many cities don't have enough green space, so they should be using, you know, the current public space that is used for other purposes, like for cars, should plant trees, get more green in the streets, whatever open spaces there are, or if there is some bigger space available, put in a little park, for example. What we're hoping to do is to update this estimates that we have every 3-4 years. So, you know, we can track progression. So hopefully what we see is that air pollution levels go down, noise goes down, we get more green space in our cities, you know, people becoming more active, and hopefully that in that way health will improve within the cities.